Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa Allah.
Allahumma rabba hadhihi ad-da'wati at-tammah wa salatu al-qa'imah wa timamah al-fatihah. Inna alhamdulillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayh wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlilhu fala hadiya lahu wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lahu له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ونشهد أن محمدا بشيرا ونذيرا وعبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد إمام المتقين وسيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كلا إن كتاب الأبرار لفي عليين وما أدراك ما عليون كتاب مرقوم يشهده المقربون إن الأبرار لفي نعيم على الأرائك ينظرون تعرف في وجوههم نظرة النعيم يسقون من رحيق مختوم ختامه مسك وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون ومزاجه من تسنيم عينا يشرب بها المقربون وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى وبشر الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أن لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار كلما رزقوا منها من ثمرة رزقا قالوا هذا الذي رزقنا من قبل وأتوا به متشابها ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة وهم فيها خالدون. Dear brothers and sisters, today we shall be talking about living through the month of Sha'ban. Today is the 27th of April and 11th of Sha'ban. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us in the month of Sha'ban so that we reap the benefits in the month of Ramadan. Sha'ban has been considered as the month of Rasulun Nabi Al-Akhir Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the upcoming month of Ramadan is the month of Ummah, where all the jaza are given directly and instantly by Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. But we are in the month of Sha'ban. Sha'ban is a very meritorious month for which we have particular instructions in the saying, in the tradition of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet described this month as his month and the month of Rajab as the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the month of Ramadan the month of Ummah. It is the 8th month of the Islamic calendar. We need to respect this month the way it was respected by Last Messenger Prophet Mohammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, far away from the innovations whatsoever have been included in this month. Narrated, Ummul Mu'mineen Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha, that Prophet never fasted in any month other than the month of Ramadan, as he fasted in the month of Sha'ban. And she asked, Ya Rasulullah, how come you are fasting after Ramadan more in this month? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, do those deeds which you can do easily, as Allah will not get tired of giving rewards till you get exhausted of performing such religious deeds. The most beloved prayer to the Prophet was the one that was won and done regularly throughout the life, even if it were little. And whenever the Prophet offered a prayer, he offered it regularly. Sahih al-Bukhari. Dear brothers and sisters, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast whole month of Sha'ban except a day or two. But he advised his companions at that time to fast in the month of Sha'ban from 1st to 15th. And in the hadith it has been mentioned, the Prophet restricted people fasting after the 15th in the month of Sha'ban. And he explained it, that I am fed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you are not me. So you have to have extra energy in the remaining 15 days so that you face the month of Ramadan comfortably. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very diligent in following what he instructed, and he showed himself by example how he fasted and also the restrictions he mentioned. Since we are now in the month of the Prophet, we should safeguard ourselves from the woe, from the misery, as we would all be resurrected on a tremendous day. The day when humankind will stand before Lord of the worlds. As a mindful believer in the religion of God, Islam, we would like that our deeds are given in our right hand and we are not questioned about our the misdeeds, what we did in the world. Certainly, the believers in one God and the believers in the tradition of the last messenger Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would not have any sadness and would not face the fearfulness on the day of resurrection. The only condition is to adhere what God has guided in the Quran and how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam excelled it through his deeds. The verses I recited from Surah Al-Mutaffifin. There is a reason for that, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by saying, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَلَّكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last among the prophets and messengers. So he has been sent as a giver of glad tidings and as a warner. But the majority of people, if we calculate out of 7 billion or so humankind, we are 1.7 billion. Even in this 1.7 billion, many of us are distracted, even don't know much about Islam, even they are fighting among themselves. But those who stick to the Atiullah wa Atiur Rasul, there is a glad tiding for them everywhere in the Quran. And the verses I recited, it says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but beware, undeniably, the record of the righteous is in Illiyin. What is Illiyin? Illiyin is in the elevated gardens. And what can you make? You recognize what Illiyin is. It is their destination recorded in a registered inscribed, which is witnessed by those brought nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of resurrection. Indeed, the righteous will be in pleasure on adorned couches observing. You will recognize in their faces the radiance of delight. They will be given the drink, pure wine which is sealed, which sips last as of musk. So for this, let the aspirants strive diligently, and its mixture is of tasneem, a spring from which those near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of resurrection and during their lifetime will drink. Indeed, it has been mentioned in the Quran, those who committed crimes against the oneness of God, as we see even in the present life and in our present days of residence, they laugh at those who believe in one God, who come to 5 days prayers, who come to attend the Jummah's prayer, and those who strive to be virtuous while residing in this world. These disbelievers and mockers against virtuous Muslims, when they pass by them, they exchange sarcastic glances physically, and also those who are fully aware of the media, especially the social media, how the Muslims are being mocked for their religious values on day-to-day basis. And when such people, not necessarily non-Muslims, some of them, they claim to be Muslims, when they gather among themselves, they would turn jesting with jokes against the believers in one God. They fail to find the difference between the peaceful Muslims and the deviant who claim Islam but commit in their life everything against Islam. Such deviants are so mesmerized with the glitters of the world that they would say about the peaceful adherents of Islam as the deviators. Though they claim the freedom of speech and they utter many, many wrong wordings against the Muslims and Islam, but when it comes to the Muslims and Islam, they are very intolerant about the freedom of speech expressed by the Muslims themselves. Certainly, believers in Islam, they put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not violate the law in the country where they live. But also they abide what is virtuous in Islam. That is the sign of a believer in Islam, especially living in the Muslim minority nation like Canada. The world over, it has been now recognized that the Muslims living in non-Muslim majority nations or Muslim minority nations, they have their own challenges. That is why Turkish government arranged a conference of the scholars who live in the Muslim minority nation. Very soon in Abu Dhabi, there will be Muslim minority nation conference also. And those scholars, those who have got the invitation all the world, they will be going inshallah. Somehow, I'll be missing that. Dear brothers and sisters, with patience and resilience in the worldly life, those who believe would be laughing. Those who believed and sustained the mocking and the accusation by the disbeliever, we Muslim believers will be laughing on the day of resurrection, will be laughing upon the disbelievers. We will be returning their laugh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the believers will be adorned in couches observing with thankfulness to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the month of Sha'ban. let us reap the benefits in the month of Sha'ban. What is proven by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The Prophet said about the fasting, none of you should fast on Friday unless he fasts before it or he fasts after it. Meaning, if somebody is habitual of fasting, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, you should fast. Should fast means if you are eligible to fast on 13th, 14th and 15th of every month. If it happened to be 13th is Thursday, 14th is Friday and 15th is Saturday, there's no problem in fasting. Even if we fast Thursday and Friday or Friday and Saturday, there is no problem. But purposefully fasting on Friday, it has been restricted by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Coming to the fasting in the month of Sha'ban, some people give very specific importance to the fasting only on 15th. Though there are no hadith on that, but there are many ulama, they support that. I say, instead of quarreling on that, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to love fasting. He used to fast Monday and Thursday. When it comes to month fasting, he recommended to fast on 13th, 14th and 15th. So let us fast on 13th, 14th and 15th if our health allows, if our timing allows. So we'll be covering inshallah ta'ala, and instead of negating others, we'll also invite them to fast rather than only one 15th. Let us fast on 13th, 14th and 15th too. There are many other celebrations, especially during the night of 14th and 15th. It is very prevalent in the Muslim world that this is the night of Bra'ah. Without commenting on that, there is no such hadith there. But there is very good authentic hadith, and whenever we follow that, we should follow by keeping that hadith in mind. Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala and mentioned, Ya Rasulullah, why you fast in this month? He said, Oh Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, don't you know that this is the month when the good deeds are lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Don't would you like to fast in this month while I fast in the month? And I fast in the month because I want my deeds to be lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while I am fasting. And fasting is a shield against all kinds of gossip. Fasting is a shield against Jahannam. And fasting is a tool for our own mindfulness while living in this world. So, as per the saying of one hadith in Sunan Abi Dawud, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, fast is a shield. When one of you is fasting, he should neither behave in an obscure manner nor foolishly. If a man fights or abuses him, he should say, I am fasting, I am fasting. Similarly, about the fasting and about the reward of it, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that Allah, the exalted and majestic, has said, every act of the son of Adam is for him except fasting. It is exclusively meant for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah alone to reward it instantly. Fasting is a shield. When any one of you is fasting on a day, he should neither indulge in obscene language nor raise the voice, or if anyone reviles him or tries to quarrel with him, he should say, I am a person in fasting. By him in whose hand is the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the breath of the observer of fast is sweeter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment than the fragrance of musk. The one who fasts has two occasions of joy. One, when he breaks the fast, he is glad with the breaking of the fast. and one when he meets his Lord on the day of resurrection, he is glad with his fast because he will remember. About the musk from the mouth, of course, there are certain conditions for that. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, brush your teeth 5 times a day so that the bad breath doesn't come out. In addition to that, we also know now flossing is very important because the food goes between the gums and that rots and that gives the smell. None of us would like that when we stand, the believer in next to us would feel bad about that bad breath. And that is why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained the importance of siwak. And he said, if I am afraid that you may injure yourself, otherwise I'll make you compulsory the siwak. My means fourth. But he did not. He just instructed and advised. Now coming back, we are the family people. We have our sisters have husbands and we have our wives. It has been said by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the voluntary siyam, voluntary fasting. The Prophet said a woman should not fast optional fasts except with her husband's permission if he is at home. It means if the woman wants to fast, first of all, she has to decide the fasting. When she decides, she should take her husband in consent so that there is no problem. And this is so much of farsightedness of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he wants the husband and wife to be as close as possible. And the Prophet always guided us how to have good relation between husband and wife. And everyone knows very well when there was a little bit of friction between Sayyidina Ali and Bibi Fatima, what he did as a father. Everybody knows about that. So we had to be very careful about the rights of others too. Then in one of the saying, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, O Abu Dhar, when you fast 3 days out of a month, then fast the 13th, 14th and 15th. This I already mentioned, but this has been mentioned in Jami Tirmidhi. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly sent the messages in the book of God. And through the last messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is mindful of Allah and obeys the messenger, there will be no fear concerning them, nor will they grieve. فَمَنْ تَبِيَ هُدَايَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. It is very simple. Certainly, those who deny the Quranic verses and are arrogant towards the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam are present in the form of ahadith sahih. A big portion of Muslims, they deny ahadith altogether. They have been referred as Ahlul Quran. So one cannot be just only following the Quran, because how the Quran was followed is in the lifestyle of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that is where we have to be very careful. Dear brothers and sisters, this is the month of Sha'ban, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided the Prophet and he elaborated the importance of the month, and deeds we commit must be according to the teachings of the Quran and of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Otherwise, any innovative deeds in the month of Sha'ban or in any times which are not proven by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is considered as innovation. كُلَّ بِدَةٍ دَلَالَةٌ وَكُلَّ دَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ وَقُولِ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ رَبِّي مِنْ كُلَّ ذَنْبٍ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahima wa ala ali Ibrahima innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahima wa ala ali Ibrahima innaka hamidun majid. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى اللهم علمنا ما جهلنا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم ربنا اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم ربنا وجعلنا مسلمين لك ومن ذريتنا أمة مسلمة لك وأرنا مناسكنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين ربنا إننا آمنا فاغفر لنا يا رب فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وقنا عذاب النار ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا رزقا واسعا وأملا متقبلا وشفاء من كل داء اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وجميع الموت المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله على نبي محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أقيم الصلاة